अनुसंधान ऑल गुजरात इंटीग्रेटेड क्लासरूम
सैटेलाइट ना माध्यम थी जोड़ती कड़ी एटले संधान।
हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर फ्रेटर्निटी, नाउ वंस अगेन वी आर getting connected through a topic which again happens to fall in Indo-Anglian literature. Now, earlier also we had seen that before 1947, when our country got free, many poets and literatures of Indian origin, they had started writing in English, which was not their mother tongue, which was a foreign language to them, but they had a nice hand in English, and on the patronage of an English officer who was the then Viceroy of Bengal, Michael Madhusudan Dutt, he started this journey. And in this journey, later on, many of our Indian poets and literatures, they joined. Now, Aurobindo, Sarojini Naidu, Rabindranath Tagore, there were a few names who joined in this fray, and they were quite successful in producing works in English. Now today I'll speak on a poem, Songs of Radha by Sarojini Naidu. Now friends, when we move ahead and before we proceed ahead, let's have a look at the personality of Sarojini Naidu. Sarojini Naidu, as she was called the Nightingale of India. She was born in 1879. And she was a noted freedom fighter and poet. Now, when this constitution bodies or constitution meetings were held, she always joined these meetings, and she was one of the architects of the Constitution of India. She was also the first woman president of the Indian National Congress, and she was the leader of first rank, because that time the elites were also joining this movement, and before Mahatma Gandhi he appeared on the horizon, Sarojini had joined this field of Indian independence, and she was a leading figure in this. Now, because of this contribution, she was also honored with this post. That is, she became the first woman president of the Indian National Congress. Her writing career started quite early in the life, because she started writing poetry when she was only 12 years of age, and it is said that she was a gifted poet. That means poetry came to her spontaneously, and she had such a vast vocabulary that she is considered as one of the most ornate poetess of not only India but of the whole world. So she started writing early, and her first collection of poems titled The Broken Axis, it was published in 1905. then mostly she chose the heroic characters, because that time in the freedom movement, all these heroic characters, they became idols for the Indian society. And in this connection, she wrote a poem, Damayanti to Nal, in the hour of exile. Then she also wrote about the pathetic position of Indian dancers. And in her poem called Indian Dancers, then later on, she moved on to write Indian Weavers. Then yet there is other beautiful poem by her, and that is titled In the Bazaars of Hyderabad. And Palki Bearers, now they are her well-known poems. She is considered, as we have seen earlier, as one of the most ornate poetess, and the language or the words or the diction which she uses in her poetry is highly figurative language. This is not the end about her poetic career. She also composed other collections like Golden Threshold, The Bird of Time, The Broken Wings, and she liked and loved youth so much that she also composed a poem called Feast of Youth, and they were composed before independence, because at that time the effect of Mahatma Gandhi, the effect of Swami Vivekananda, the effect of Aurobindo and Tagore was also prevailing, and literature and Indian independence freedom fight, you know, they were going together. Now in this poem which we have before us, this is the Songs of Radha, A Quest. And as we know that a song is that which is sung. So here the great poetess Sarojini, she is singing a song which comprises Radha. Now this historic character Radha, we are all acquainted with this fact that Radha is considered as the beloved of Lord Krishna, because Lord Krishna, he married with Rukmani, but much before he got married, and when he was like as a child, you know, in the streets of Braj, so from that time onwards the love songs of Krishna and Radha, they were sung in the streets of Braj, or it is in other words Gokul. Now here in this poem or we can call it song also, Radha is the major character, and she is seeking for her love, that is Krishna. And how she starts, you know, so let's start the poem. Radha says, my foolish love went seeking thee at dawn, crying o wind, where Kanhaiya gone. So the poetess starts the poem, and she puts words in the mouth of Radha. Radha says that my foolish love, that means my foolish Kanhaiya, my foolish Krishna, I am seeking for thee. Thee means I am seeking for Lord Krishna at dawn. Now when the day rises, all of us know that it is dawn. Dawn means when the sun rises. So as soon as the sun rises in the sky, I go out to seek the whereabouts of my love, the person who resides in my bosom, and he is none other than Krishna. So I am trying my best to locate him. And she says, she asks the wind, and she addresses the wind as crying, O. See the usage of this word, crying, O wind, the wind which is crying. So you tell me, crying, O wind, where is Kanhaiya? So Radha is not sure. She is not able to meet her love, and therefore she, as soon as she wakes up in the morning, as soon as the sun rises in the sky, she goes out in the search of Kanhaiya or Krishna. And when she is not able to get a glimpse of her love, she asks a natural factor, that is wind, about the whereabouts of Krishna. I questioned at noon rise the forest glade. Rest my sweet lover in thy friendly shade. Then she moves ahead and she questions, Radha says, that this time is not now nearly noon rise, or we may say that this is nearly 10 o'clock, and she has not been able to locate Kanhaiya till this point. So she starts feeling frustrated and she questions the forest glade. Now, since it is going to be noon rise and she has entered forest, so there, that sparkling which she finds in the forest, and she calls it the forest glade. So she questions the forest glade, and the time is noon rise, and the question is that my lover Kanhaiya, is he lying in your shade? Rest my sweet lover in thy friendly shade. That means she is not sure, but she questions the forest glade, that has Kanhaiya come here? Has he taken shelter in your shade, which is quite lovely? Now, again, she doesn't get any answer, and she moves ahead. And now, this time is dusk. From dawn, she started and she has come up to the dusk. The sun has set. So, the sun has set. The sun has set behind the mountains. Now, Radha, she pleads with the dove grey tides. The lines are, at dusk I pleaded with the dove grey tides, oh tell me where my flute player abides. So now see the use of these words. The time is now, the day is over. Radha has labored a lot. She started in the morning. She tried to find out her lover in the afternoon, but she cannot locate him at any of the places, at any of the times, and the dusk is there. So she pleads. Now when she has got tired, she has got no option left except pleading. She requests, because she has accepted her defeat. So she pleads with the dog grey tides. The tides are there, the sea is there, and its color is nearly dog grey, because tides are of dove gray color. So she pleads the sea or the tides, "Oh, tell me where my flute player abides. You tell me." The forest is unable to tell. The wind is unable to tell. "You please tell me." She requests the tides. "You please tell me, where is my flute player?" Because as we, this is a historic reference, because all of us are well acquainted with this fact that Krishna played flute, and he is considered as one of the greatest flute players of the world. So by the use of this word, the poetess in the form of Radha, she urges the tides or the sea to tell her where resides or where abides the flute player or the Kanhaiya. Again, she finds no answer. Dumb were the waters, dumb the woods, the wind. They know not where my play fellow to find. The fourth couplet comes. Now this poem, you see, it's in couplets. It doesn't have any kind of stanzas, but couplets are there. So in the fourth couplet, Naidu says, "Dumb were the waters, water could not answer. Dumb the woods, woods were silent." Woods means forest, jungle we also tell it. The wind had no answer, and all were tired because the wind, the woods, the waters, nobody knew. They know not where my play fellow to find. And they were not sure where to find this fellow, or as the Radha calls him, her play fellow, because they used to play together. And now she is in a playing mood. So she started in the morning at dawn to find the playmate. But now